We have company ABCD trading at $50 a share. Let's draw a payoff diagram for a put option with a $50 strike price trading at $10. So once again, we're going to draw two types of payoff diagrams. One type that only cares about the value of the option at expiration. And this is what you tend to see in academic settings, business schools, or textbooks. And then the other one will actually draw the profit and loss based on that option position. And so it incorporates the price you actually paid for the option. You tend to see this more in practice. So you have a put option. Remember, this is the right to sell. This is the right to sell the stock at $50. So if the stock, let's say at expiration, so all of this is at expiration. If at expiration, the stock is trading at zero, the company went bankrupt, it's now worthless. What is the put option worth? Well, you would now go onto the market, buy it for pennies, or buy it for almost $0, and then you would exercise your put option, and you would sell it for $50. So you would definitely exercise, and you would make a lot of money. If the underlying stock could be bought for zero, the put option is now worth $50, because you can buy it for zero and then sell it for $50 if you have the put option. If the underlying stock price is $10, then you still could go buy the stock for $10. If you have the option, you would exercise the option to sell it at $50, so you would make $40. So the option would be worth $40. Anyone who's holding the option would make an instant $40. So it goes, the value of the option becomes less and less as the value of the stock becomes more and more, up until you get to $50. At $50, you wouldn't really care. You have the right to sell something at $50, which you could buy for $50. So it's kind of worth nothing. So the value of the put option, it starts at $50 because you have the right to sell something that's worthless at $50 if the stock were to go bankrupt then. And then at $50, it becomes the option you don't really has, it doesn't have any value anymore. And if the stock goes anything above $50, it still is worthless. If the stock is at $100 or something like that, there's no way you would exercise the option, because why would you exercise the right to sell something at $50, where on the open market you could sell it at $100? Now let's do the same thing for the profit and loss version. So if the stock is worth nothing, you could buy it for nothing, and then if you have the option, sell it for $50. But we have to incorporate the fact that you paid $10 for the option. So instead of saying that the option is worth $50, we would say it's worth $50 minus this $10. So it would be worth $40. And this is all the way you would exercise the option, all the way until the option is worth $50. But at $50, instead of saying it's worthless, you have to remember, if the stock is $50, you wouldn't exercise the option, but you did pay $10 for it. So you wouldn't exercise something that you paid $10 for, so you would have to take a $10 loss. So the option starts at $50 and becomes worth less, 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 and less, all the way to the point that if you don't exercise it, you took the loss of paying for an option and not exercising it. And then any stock price above that, you just took a $10 loss.